Howdy, howdy, neighbors. This is DJ Davenport welcoming you and yours to Access to Bluegrass, a bluegrass show brought to you every week at this time by this station. And here is a fine bluegrass band playing their little hearts out for you. And with no further ado, here they are.
Television land, you don't know if they're real. But then, what do you know with regards to reality in television land? It's like calling in for a free reading. Four walls, two chairs, and a doorway to a room that has always stayed close. Sometimes that door can be opened by someone that you used to know. It's been many long years since I'd seen her. I got a letter just yesterday. It came like the rain out of nowhere. And here's what she had to say. Years have gone by, some good and some bad, but I never stop thinking about the times that we had. So meet me tomorrow where we used to go. She signed it, someone that you used to know. To get to be on television, so I have a reason to introduce the band. And let me just take a second to do that in the television way. It's always a wonderful honor to get to pick with such good musicians. Actually, Mary Jo Leet, a wonderful singer, well-known voice throughout the field of bluegrass music, and this is a song from her Escape. Lost like grain of sand upon sand of time, and believing in a love I thought was mine. Tossed just like a ship on the waves of a storm, I find myself alone, but tomorrow I'll be gone. I'll be gone when your blinded eyes open wide to see. You're a loser in that game of love played so carelessly.
Called in love faithful like a bird that has flown. And now you're left alone, cause tomorrow I'll be gone. Gone like leaves and falls to return no more. That is how you left me like the other one before. Oh, blessing love my, but now it is torn. Marked in little pieces, but tomorrow I'll be gone. I'll be gone when your blinded eyes open wide to see. You're a loser in that game of love, played so carelessly. I called you love faithful like a bird in the storm. And now you're left alone, cause tomorrow I'll be gone. Called your new love faithful like a bird that has flown. And now you're left alone, cause tomorrow I'll be gone.
Thank you very much. Thank you a lot. I think she learned that song off Wilma Lee Cooper at a time when, and of course Mary Jo's been in this band for 35 years. She was only 1 year old when she started.
Thank you.
But one of the first jobs we ever had was we was playing the Coal Miners College in Beckley, West Virginia. A lot of city slickers probably don't even think a lot of miners has a college education. And they was having a big convention of the Women Coal Miners of America, who are your pretty hardcore feminists. And they're right up there with the women truck drivers of America for not taking no lip off anybody. And we went down and played some music with one of the world's greatest woman activists. Her name's Hazel Dickens, and she's about the only woman I ever knew man enough to show up at an organization like that with a mostly male orchestra. And she did that song, and then Mary Jo said, well, I think I'm going to have it. And since she happened to be of the right gender, they let her. She's had to answer for me singing along ever since then. As I walked in the roadside tavern, the smell of drink was in the air. I threw my money on the counter. This pretty young maid was standing there. My thoughts they drifted so far from me. As I looked upon her smiling face, I knew she was my kind of woman. No one on earth could take her place. Said when working hours are over, I would just love to see you home. She said, young man, that is my pleasure. And soon we found ourselves alone. We throwed our arms around each other. I felt the knife stick in her back. She turned and saw her lover running. Said his name is Barring Jack. She did not know love or fun. She did not know he was around. And still pain and death had struck her. And now she's sleeping in the ground. I sit alone tonight in prison. My thoughts are of that girl so fair. And I meant one night in Roadside Tavern when the smell of drink was in the And the other great singer in this band is Adam McIntosh. He likes to sing them songs where he has to work real hard. No, don't make me sing them hard-working songs again. And he's a wonderful guitar player and a good guy to carry your stuff around when you get real old. And I hardly ever introduce a bass player, and there's a good reason for this. Like, I got a place down in Kentucky called the International Bluegrass Music Museum. And in it, they have a guy called the curator. And so he goes around and curates stuff. And whenever you go, or if you ever get to go there, he not only curates things, but he's got a lot of professional advisors that got the university professors and people with PhDs and people from the intellectual ferment crowd, a Harvard Community College, a lot of different people can consult with a curator. And so whenever they get ready to curate something, they'll consult with all these people and get every information you can think of. And so whenever you go to the International Bluegrass Music Museum, first of all, there's not a lot of familiar faces there, because you got to admit, up to about a year ago, if it wasn't for Allison Krauss, you could have took everybody that ever played a note of bluegrass music and put them on one side of the street and put the general public over on the other side of the street, and the general public would have said, who are them Gomers? But now we have Allison Krauss. What happens is you can put everybody that ever played a note of bluegrass music on one side of the street and the general public on the other side of the street, and they'll look over and say, who are them Gomers over there with Allison Krauss? But this has all been corrected now by the greatest Gomer of all, Ralph Stanley, country male vocalist of the year. He waited a while. You got to be in a lot of knife fights when you're Ralph Stanley. See, because it gives me a lot of faith, though, because finally a good singer got it, and not just the hunk du jour. And not to say now, I hope Ralph doesn't get his award. He says, I'm not a hunk. He's a well-known hunk. Anyways, told you that to tell you this. Whenever you go to the museum, they don't have all these famous people. You know, you go in and the first thing you ever see, totally curated, all the intellectual advice you could have, is a picture, a great big blown-up picture right at the main entrance of the first bluegrass band. And they got their instruments and everything, and underneath they've identified everyone in the band. They got guitar, Lester Flatt, banjo, Earl Scruggs, fiddle, Chubby Wise, mandolin, Bill Monroe, bass player, unknown. Like, introduce our guy that plays the bass, this guy. Right. And you know, like, I could tell you his name, but you're going to forget, like, because it's, who cares? He's a bass player, right? That's Charlie Lee, plays bass and sings. And getting ready to fire up a banjo number, one of the best banjo players you're ever going to get to hear. He used to play in this band years ago, and he what happened was he got to dreaming of owning a house. And so he quit and went and played country music. And He got to owning two houses. Or he had two houses. He said, I believe I got enough houses. I can go back and play bluegrass. And we're glad to have him back in the band. But the problem is now he's down to one house again. And I'm just worried he's going to have to take a mortgage out on it if he keeps playing bluegrass music. But in country music, we're getting ready to fire him up on the banjo here because he's still not in real good shape. He's only been back by a year or so. And see, in country music, he played the pedal steel. And I don't know if you ever actually seen anybody play the pedal steel. Now, I ain't saying nothing about how hard the work is in the pedal steel line of endeavor, but it looks something like this to me. Of course, it's not as hard as I'm making it look. Because you're sitting down when you do it. And that's actually what I wanted to tell you, because we was getting ready to make a record, and he brought his pedal steel over. And all I can say is, now I realize a lot of you people watch this public television is real rich. But you can't consider yourself actually wealthy unless you own your own pedal steel chair. You might have a big mansion, a whole big set of furniture, somebody come in, done your interior, decorate and everything, but if they didn't put Harry pedal steel in there, pedal steel chair, then you may as well call them back, because there is, it's the most wonderful piece of furniture. I'm pretty sure they got the idea for the pedal steel chair from them old circus cars where 50 clowns climbed out. Because he brought his pedal steel chair over, he's got two refrigerators, Fahrenheit and centigrade. You can't own enough stuff that you couldn't get in your pedal steel chair. If you're getting ready to go out and rent storage space, don't bother. Go buy you a pedal steel chair. And then not only could you sit on it and have all these things, you could try this sometime. Hey. So I just told you that so you could see how hard this is compared to that, this banjo picking stuff. And his name is Danny Russell. I can't recall her name. I had a baby brother who I'll never see again. For the children's home is sending us out on the orphan train to try and find someone to take us in. Take us in. We have rode the orphan train. Take us in. We need a home. We need a name. Take us in. Oh, won't you be our kin? We are looking for someone to take us in. City streets. I've swung the bars and pools for a little bite to eat. In my daddy's old green jacket and these rags upon my feet, I'm just looking for someone to take me in. Take us in. We have rode the orphan train. Take us in. We need a home. We need a name. Take us in. Oh, won't you be our kin? We are looking for someone to take us in. Children's home, they gathered us, me and all the rest. They taught us to sit quietly until the food was blessed. Then they put us on the orphan train and sent us way out west to try and find someone to take us in. Take us in. We have rode the orphan train. Take us in. We need a home. We need a name. Take us in. Oh, won't you be our kin? We are looking for someone. All the farmers and their families that came from miles around, we lined up on the platform at the station in each town. And one by one we parted like some living lost and found. And one by one we all were taken in. Take us in. We have rode the orphan train. Take us in. We need a home. We need a name. Take us in. Oh, won't you be our kin? We are looking for someone to take us in. Now there's many a fine doctor or teacher in your school. There's many a good preacher who can teach the golden rule. Who started out an orphan, sleeping in the freezing rain. His life began out on the orphan train. Take us in. We have rode the orphan train. Take us in. We need a home. We need a name. Take us in. Oh, won't you be our kin? We are looking for someone. Take us in. Take us in. We have rode the orphan train. Take us in. We need a home. We need a name. Take us in. Oh, won't you be our kin? We are looking for someone to take us in.
Well, it looks like the old clock on the wall has caught up with us, and it's time to pack up our gear and get out of here and let another fine program come on. Thank you so much for watching. We really appreciate that. And we appreciate the cards and letters and emails and telephone calls, whatever. We really appreciate those, folks. It makes this all worthwhile. And we want to thank our people behind the scenes, our whole crew. There's a bunch of them, so I can't name all of them. Until next time, this is DJ Davenport wishing you and yours the very, very best. And take care of one another. You couldn't take care of nicer people. Bye.